Guys, welcome to this analysis. I will actually take in consideration the victory of Belgium 5-2 over this Tunisia. Tunisia that was not actually bad, but they were actually not capitalizing, not finalizing the goal chances that they have. What do they miss? They have a nice player. I will always say this, like the North African Shaqiri, like Kasri, the guy that scored actually. He can dribble, he can create a lot of chances. He's actually a very nice player. And then I don't know why they were actually playing with Zliti on the bench. Zliti is probably one of the biggest talents that they have in the team. This is very weird, but what they need a striker that capitalize all the chances that they create. It's not a bad team. They were actually doing a good game, but then in front of them, there's one of the teams that have the highest chance to win this World Cup, and I'm speaking about Belgium. Belgium is not weak in any of the team parts. He has a great defense. He has a great midfield. Honestly, I was expecting Witsel to be a bit rusty after this experience in China, but I cannot see that. And they have a great attack, and they also have a great bench. I actually will focus on some players. Of course, they have also great goalkeeper with Courtois. Well, some actually few weeks back, I was speaking about Thomas Meunier as a substitute, a great substitute for Cancelo in Inter, and people were complaining saying, "Ah, oh, this player cannot be decisive in attack." And today, of course, as always, it happens to me, so like 90% of the times, I prove these people wrong, because honestly, this guy can do everything. He has also great pace. He can dribble, he can assist. He's one of the best, in my opinion, right backs in the world. And he's not playing in PSG. We have to actually to take that advantage to cut a good deal. In midfield, as I said, they have a great midfield with Witsel, that is a playmaker that I appreciate a lot. He can actually direct the actions pretty well. I don't see like a decreasing on his performances due to the fact that he's playing in a not top league like Chinese league. Also they have players like Fellaini and Tielemans on the bench, and that tells a lot about the quality of this team. Finally, there's a team that can play with 4-2-3-1. Football always goes with fashion. Now we have the fashion of 4-2-3-1, but not all the team can afford to play with that system. With that system, you need a striker that can actually handle the pressure on himself of all the attacking. And then you have to have attacking midfielders, very good attacking midfielders, also on attacking the goal when there's space created by the number 9. And Belgium, they have all of this. They have Lukaku, that is a great striker. Actually, in the bench, they have Batshuayi, that to me reminds me of Drogba. Today, yes, he was wasting few chances, but honestly, he was there to score, and that's something that you have to take in consideration as well. Then they have a Kevin De Bruyne that can do everything he wants with the right and left foot. No difference for him. They have an Eden Hazard that, in my opinion, is a Ballon d'Or level football player. Honestly, as Fabregas said in a last interview, if he wants to win the Ballon d'Or, it's just upon himself. And then they have Dries Mertens. What can I say about Dries Mertens? He can dribble two, three men and score us all a goal, or actually assist Lukaku with the one touch. He's like very complete football player. What I'm saying is 4-2-3-1. They have to play the player to deliver this system. Some other teams, they don't. I actually saw teams with like for example Morocco, or for example I could take in consideration sometimes Italy as well was trying to play with that system. Argentina, you don't have the players to do that. Just change the system. Football should not follow the fashion. So Belgium was impressing me. It was not, it's not a surprise, that's for sure. But I actually like the solidity of the team, the overall balance and the solidity of the team. And also they have top players at the highest shape of their career. Tell me what you think, comment below, and please share and subscribe. I thank you a lot for the support, and see you in the next video. Ciao.